Hey guys, today I'm going to try an experiment here. I've got this Tillotson carburetor hooked directly to the tank with no fuel pump whatsoever. Now I heard rumors of people running these, but I don't know if it's ever been done because I've never tried it. Every time I've run a Tillotson, I've always run a fuel pump. And got a little bite there, but I think it was just running on the carb spray I put in there. And my little table here is kind of rinky-dink. I'm going to have to get a better setup than this. I'm going to try opening these fuel screws up a little bit. This is the low speed, and this is the high. I'm going to turn them up, turn them out another turn or so. We'll see. And I'm going to set the idle up because I really can't reach over there and grab that throttle very well. Try choking it. Yeah, it's just not gonna happen. You know, if your engine doesn't start the first time or two, it's not gonna start. I clamped it down a little bit better, but I'm still not having any luck. It's just not wanting to run without a fuel pump. Well, let's go back to the bench here. And let's install a fuel pump. Now, before I'm going to go ahead and take this tank off, but I want to try to keep the tank and still run a fuel pump. So I may hang one off the carburetor back here or something. Because the mini bike this is going on doesn't have an external tank, and I really don't want to go to the trouble to put one on there. But I had thought about using a top plate, and I had bought one off the bay place, but there's really no sense in using it on this because I'm not going to need the throttle linkage or anything. But I think I will just kind of rob the fuel pump. It's got one of those little plastic fuel pumps in it, and it's just a pulse pump. It operates off of vacuum pulse. And check out this top plate while I'm in here. That looks pretty good. I think that's stainless. Or it could be aluminum brushed. I don't know. Boy, it looks good. Well, that would certainly look good on there. But, yeah, not for this one, though. I'm just going to go ahead and mount that tank back on there. And this is what I need out of this kit. The little pulse pump. And I can't see using that top plate just to mount that fuel pump, so. Now, in order to get a pulse fitting in this thing, I'm going to drill this valve cover, and I'm going to mark it right about here. Just mark yours anywhere below, you know, kind of out of the way of the spark plug, and below that top layer, you know, up top there, it's got the, well, that was a little fast. You could pause the video, guys, if you want to look back in there, but up at the top layer, that's where it's kind of like a PCV valve, and that ventilates your crankcase pressure. And down below it, that's where you want to drill for your pulse fitting. But, you know, just keep in mind, you know, don't want to put it right behind the spark plug or anything like that. That'll be in your way. So just off to one side. And this is a diagram of that fuel pump, how these little plastic ones work. If you get one like this, you know, that's how it'll work for you. You got an inlet, a pulse, and an outlet. This one here is the fuel inlet. This one here is the pulse line, the orange line going to the fitting over there. Let me get this plug wire out of the way so you guys can see. And that's just a quarter inch barb fitting. I just screwed into the valve, drilled the valve cover, screwed that in there. And I've got a little short fuel line going on from the output to the Tillotson carburetor. And I could zip tie that, but for right now, I'm just going to let it hang. I just want to make sure everything's working like it's supposed to be. I can strengthen that up later. I don't think it's going anywhere, though. Fuel line's pretty much holding it in place. But that'll let me use my fuel tank, and that's what I really want. And no, it should have hit off by now. No, something's wrong. Okay, I'm sitting here thinking about it, and then I realize I did not bleed the air out of the system. So I'm going to pull this fuel line off there and give it a yank or so there and kind of like let that pulse and clear out the air out of the line. There we go. We just want fuel. We don't want air over fuel because that won't work real well. Oh boy, that won't work real well with a Tillotson diaphragm. You can pop those if you're not careful. And I have made a mess with gas. At current prices, that was probably $12 worth. So I think I'm going to go ahead and take this thing outside, let that air dry a little bit. Now I've got a little bit better set up here. Hopefully this will be a little more sturdy than that plastic table. And we have a winner. Oh, it's rich. Very rich. Gotta hold that choke open. Don't need any choke, that's for sure. I've got to turn this low speed in. I had it wound out about 2.5 rounds trying to get it to run a few minutes ago. I'm going to turn it back in a little bit. Alrighty. Lower my idle speed now. I'm going to run it up some more. And where I ended up at, you know, it would have been right at 1.25 turns out. So, yeah. Oh yeah, that's much better. Oh yeah. So again, this little diagram thing here, guys, just, you know, you can pause this. If you want to run those little cheap pumps, you know, they're pretty good. That's all I got for today. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.